time for me to update you folks on the Kraken giveaway and let you know where this thing is headed. So I'm going to put this down because it's heavy and instead pick up my notes because we got a little bit to talk about here. So obviously I had no idea how many people would get in touch when I said, send me an email if you'd like the Kraken. I'd be happy to send it to one of you. This channel is fairly small in the grand scheme of YouTube, around 20,000 subscribers, which honestly doesn't mean much because the typical video only gets like 1,000 to 2,000 views. Not that I'm not thankful for that, but I'm just saying that, let's be realistic here, I'm tiny compared to many other YouTubers, or whatever you want to call YouTube people. As of today, the previous Kraken video has about 1,500 views. Of those 1,500 views, 60 emailed me about the Kraken, which makes up about 4% of the views of the video. That's 60 emails with great, different, amazing stories from a whole heap of different people. Interestingly, about 50% of those 60 emails came from the United States of America. Quite a large portion of my views are in the USA, that and Australia obviously, but yeah, 50% were from the USA. Speaking of Australia, that was the other largest population of emails. Around about 25% of the emails I received were from Aussies. Half of those were from New South Wales. The other half were an equal split of Queensland and Victoria. So interestingly, none of the other states. Then curiously, the next most common country was Sweden, of all places. I don't know how or why, but for some reason, MX5s in Sweden must be a popular thing. Or perhaps they like Australians. Or perhaps they're just a bit frugal and they can't shy away from a freebie. But nonetheless, hello to my Swedish viewers. Then there was a mix of European countries for the most part, Germany, Netherlands, Spain, that sort of thing, which was great, and a couple from the UK. Not sure if they're still considered European anymore, Brexit and all that. Curiously, no viewers or no emails from any Asian continent or anyone from the Asian continent, which was interesting. And also nothing from Canada, given the population of Canada, what, 40 million people now? So quite a bit more than Australia, certainly what, 10% or less of, or a bit more than that of the USA. So not huge, but a fairly big country. I would have thought USA and Canada fairly close together, similar demographic. Perhaps they'd be equally interested in this video, but I don't know. Anyway, to the Canadians out there, hello. Of those emails, almost everyone did as I'd hoped and sent me some sort of picture of their car, which I was very pleased to see. There were a few standouts of various, shall we say, genres of car, from clean original stuff to kind of street cars with a bit of tweaking done to them to kind of full-on track cars, full-on track beasts. For the sake of privacy, I won't reveal too much in terms of names or locations or anything, but there are a few special mentions I do want to cover off. Firstly, this red NA from Germany with the white wheels. I really like the look. It looks like a fairly original car, fairly clean. I love the photo, the scenery, and the white wheels kind of give it this rally car feel, which I like the vibe. There was this black on black NB with the yellow brake calipers. I'm pretty sure they're standard factory brake calipers that have just been painted. But nonetheless, it had this sort of stealthy, aggressive street look, which I enjoyed. There was a yellow NA from the USA, which was kind of giving me Beaver motor pants vibes, real tingly in the pants kind of feel. Time Attack style car, really racy. Loved the look of that thing. And one of the last ones on the list was a silver NB from New Zealand. I don't know what it was, whether it was the photography or just the really clean paint job or something, but it just popped. The photos really popped. The car just looked great. Had this kind of aggressive street look to it. Maybe a little too aggressive for my style, but definitely one of the top of my list of all those that were emailed to me. There were a few folks that also tugged at the heartstrings, people with, including photos of their kids with their car or a dog with their car. It's hard to turn, say no and sorry, don't get the Kraken to a person who's got the photo of their little child in their car saying, oh, I work on it with my son or my child or my daughter or whatever it is. Heartstrings were pulled there, but nonetheless, one of the most heartbreaking photos was a photo of an NA British Racing Green from the UK, completely burnt out. Some people had stolen it and burnt the car to a crisp. So that one hurt to see. There were so many others, so thank you to all of you who emailed me nonetheless. I really valued reading every single email. Now, in terms of the Kraken itself, I've already reached out to all of the 60 odd people that emailed and let them know of the results. So this video is more so to update you keen folk on just what happened. Obviously, I had to make a choice of one out of that 60, which left 59 people that were somewhat unhappy with the result. But I spent a good number of hours going over all the emails and the photos and all of the stories that everyone wrote to make a informed decision, try to be as non-biased and try to take everything in and give everyone equal chance. To help me find that new home for the Kraken, I put together a bit of a scorecard idea in a spreadsheet in Excel and went through every single email and ranked them all, scored them all on the photos and the stories and all the interesting things I thought they told me and all this, what I thought of their car, and avoided any biases on car style because everyone has their own thing. So obviously some people like the track look, certainly that's sort of typically my thing. Some people like the clean, genuine car, certainly I can appreciate that. And some people like crazy street cars or things that you kind of wonder, wow, does that even drive? But nonetheless, I tried to not bias towards or against any of those and just enjoy them for what they were. And try to not have a preference of a one particular style. The top spot of all of the emails on the list was granted to an email that came with a lovely, lovely imagery of an amazing car, a fantastic story with ups and downs that are typical of MX-5 ownership, a person that was clearly, had been with the car for a long time, had passion for their car. They put a lot of time and effort into the car, a lot of modifications, but also maintenance, keeping it up to date, bringing it back from the dead, so to speak. And I really appreciated that commitment and passion that they had to their car. And as such, I'm very happy to say that the Kraken is headed off on a plane trip or a boat ride or whatever couriers do these days with coronavirus things. It's headed off to a chap in Sweden, quite a ways away from here, if you know your geography. I don't want to say too much about who they are or any of that. I don't want to, you know, mess up with the privacy world. It's for them to decide how they want to break the news to their friends and family. I'll just put this photo here. I hope they enjoy their lucky New Year's present. To end, I just want to say thanks to you folks for making all of this possible. I hope that you can join me in the satisfaction of knowing that there's a dude in the MX-5 world who's just had their 2021 start off with quite a positive note, and he's hoping that you all enjoy this year as well. 2020 was pretty crazy. Anyway, that's it for this one. Thanks for watching.